A woman can't go off running around the world doing as she pleases, having fun. Oh, no. We're the guardians of morals and manners. That's why you put us on your silly pedestal so we can't move a step without falling off.
Well, you know, she was a huge international movie star. And, of course, I'd seen her do many, many films. But I think the first impression was her beauty.
You are a very beautiful girl, you know, and I was simply carried away, ma'am.
You're lucky that you weren't blown away.
She wasn't somebody who would necessarily want to walk out of the elevator in a hotel and have everybody turn around and look, but she knew that was going to happen just because of how she was. She walked into the room and you were looking at a Hollywood star of a particular time and place.
She was more interested in and involved in life around her than she was concerned about her own incredible beauty, which she just took for granted.
My goodness, you're beautiful.
You work with excellent people. Suddenly, woof, you know, like playing tennis. You get to be a better tennis player. What a treat, for want of a better word, to have Maureen O'Hara as your mother.
Do you miss me?
Mm-hmm. Do you miss me?
She was very strong, you know. She was an Irish Colleen.
Look at me clean floor, you dirty little...
Such a gob!
Ah, shut you, me little man. Here.
She was used to getting her own way and standing up to people, which you have to do in the movie business, or you just get, you know, kicked around.
You know, women folk listen to what I say. Is that clear for you?
You pompous, foul-smelling tyrant!
And there were some actresses that drove Duke crazy because they wouldn't really look at it. He loves you to really look at it. I think the chemistry between Maureen and Duke was wonderful.
Her favorite men really were, from the movies, really was John Wayne and John Ford. She just loved them. Loved them.
There was an electricity there, but she could match John Wayne. Kiss for kiss, punch for punch, you know, stride for stride.
It's a bold one you are. And who gave you leave to be kissing me?
So you can talk.
Yes, I can, I will, and I do.
She never lost touch with her roots and who she was, and I don't think was overly impressed or dazzled anyway by the great and the powerful, the heads of studios, you know. She said what she felt. That was it.